Hello, welcome to our channel IAC Steno. We're starting the passage at speed of 110 word per minute. Start. Mr. Deputy Chairman, I am entirely in sympathy with the purpose underlying the resolution moved by my honorable friend. As I see it, the resolution seeks to inquire into the causes of increase in expenditure and suggest measures for affecting economy. Sir, I do not think that there can be two opinions on the need for such a probe into the causes for the increase in civil expenditure that we are noticing. Whether the expenditure is justified or not is another matter, but somehow the country and the House have the wrong impression that civil expenditure has been increasing at a phenomenal rate after the launching of the 5-year plans. So, sir, to set at rest such notions that these increases are unjustified, at least the government ought to agree to look into the causes for the increase in expenditure. I agree that a commission may not be the most suitable machinery for having such a probe, a commission consisting of members of parliament, but it is immaterial. What machinery is set up to investigate into the whole position? I would go to the extent of saying that government may think how best to inquire into and what machinery would be most suitable for inquiring into the rise in civil expenditure in recent years. Sir, I do not want to weary the House with facts and figures, but let me point out at the outset that the problem has to be viewed objectively. One honorable member said that having regard to the high ideals set up by the father of the nation, the expenditure that is being incurred by the government in the name of 5-year plans is extremely high, and that we should be guided by the standards set up by Gandhiji. There was the other extreme point of view where one member urged that because we are engaged in national reconstruction, the whole administrative machinery is geared to the implementation of the plans, so that there can be no distinction between plan expenditure and non-plan expenditure, and so everything is justified. This was the opposite view. We should steer clear of these two extreme views and see how far the rise in expenditure is justified by the tempo of developmental activity, how far it is a waste and how far it could be eliminated. Sir, this problem has to be looked at from the larger perspective, from the limited point of view of reducing unnecessary expenditure. It is desirable, but there is the larger question, and it is this. We are, as the House is aware, engaged in implementing 5-year plans. During the 10th plan, there has been a very large increase in civil expenditure, as pointed out by the 92nd report of the Estimates Committee. Sir, as I said, this question has larger implications than the immediate needs of affecting economy in civil expenditure. To me, it appears that this question is intimately tied up with the question of administrative reforms. We have seen that administrative reforms are on the anvil, but the nature and extent of these reforms are not yet clear, and the House has had no opportunity to discuss them, but reference was made by one or two friends to friends to the reports on the question of reforms, but the reports related only to the need for reorganization of the secretariat and did not relate to the question of rise in civil expenditure. Sir, as can be seen from this report, the expenditure has been rising steadily, and when the expenditure has gone up by nearly 60% during the first 4 years of the 10th plan period, I shudder to think what would be the rise in civil expenditure at this rate during the 11th plan period, when the outlay is going to be double that of the 10th plan. Sir, we have to remember that era of planning and the outlay on our 5-year plans is going to increase from plan to plan. We have been through 10 5-year plans and we are at the end of the 10th plan period. And this, I think, is the opportune time when we should review working of the administrative machinery and the extent of civil expenditure vis a vis the outlay on developmental activities, unless we have a probe into the state of affairs at this juncture. A time will come when the departments and the governmental machinery will have multiplied themselves to such an extent that it will be difficult to control expenditure and to find out where the defect lies. It will be difficult to reorganize the administrative machinery. So it seems to me that the question of administrative reforms is intimately tied up with the question of reduction of civil expenditure. If the strength and the functions are very efficiently defined at various levels, then it will be easy to control expenditure. Administrative personnel are to be increased in promotion only to the outlay for the plan. Thank you.